Doop doop doop. Okay, now that I completed everything with... Congratulations, are you ready? Okay, I can't do more. I'm light red. Check-ins. Still need to do that. Still need to do that. Ryder has his new thing. Yeah, let's just go ahead and do that. Storytelling, let's see. Oh, I didn't do any. Okay, whatever. All of these? Let me wrap them up for you. Sorry, sir. You mentioned you wanted some lighthearted movies? Sorry, I got it wrong. It was disaster documentaries. I think there's something I haven't done yet. What was it? Caesar sent a message earlier inviting us to the Outer Ring. Ah, right. Sorry, I'll check you out right now. Bill, I'll stay and watch over the store. You head to the Outer Ring first. I'll join old Enzo later for the test drive of his new modified car. I'll head out to the Outer Ring first then. See you tonight. After arriving at Blazewood, you are unable to reach Caesar, but a familiar friend is just ahead. I have 5 minutes to do that. No idea what all that is. Okay. Why they can't? Yay, thank you. Go ahead, do it. Recommend. Open. I'm gonna get like 5 Denny, but who cares? Hi, Howl, please. Let me get these, Okay.
Are you going for this time?
Right.
Is that it? Come back next time, you hear?
Yeah. Aww. so majestic. Nope. Proxy, so you're here already. Caesar's caught up with some stuff for settlement days, so she sent me to get you. So this celebration is called Settlement Days? Well, Settlement Days aren't exactly a festival. How should I put it?
Let me give you an example. Say your gang gets into it with another gang, and you get sucker punched. But not long after, the two gangs make peace. Wouldn't you still be a little pissed?
Yeah.
Yeah, not just a little pissed. I'd be mega mad.
Exactly. That's what settlement days are for. In the Outer Ring, nobody just lets stuff like that slide. Even though Caesar's the new overlord now, there's still some unfinished business between the gang members. They've got 3 days to settle their beef by challenging each other. After that, it's time to let it go and move on.
Ah.
In these challenges, both sides put something on the line. Kind of like a wager, and winner takes all.
Sounds serious.
Whoa, those duels sound intense. But, wait, hold on. Am I even supposed to be at something like this?
Yeah, it used to be pretty hardcore, but it's much more chill this year. After all, Caesar's not the type to hold grudges, and no one will come looking for trouble. This year's duels are mostly stuff like target shooting, rock, paper, scissors, tongue twisters, and the stakes are silly things like stale bread or a rabbit someone grabbed from their backyard. Oh, I just saw two gangs having a contest over who had the longer cat.
Oh my god. So this is just an excuse for you guys to do stupid shit.
Sounds more like a fair.
Pretty much. But hey, Caesar's having a blast, so I guess that's just the new overlord's vibe. Since you're here, Proxy, if there's anything you're not happy about from our last job, now's the time to settle it.
I just remembered something.
Things I'm not happy about. Actually...
Why are you looking at me like that? You're not holding a grudge against me, are you?
Remember Eos?
You stepped on Eos's foot back in the hollow! Boy, that really hurt!
Oh, really? Sorry, I'll watch where I'm stepping next time. But hey, that's a perfect excuse for a nitro fuel drink-off. What do you say, Proxy?
Nitro fuel, huh?
You just want some nitro fuel, don't you?
That's not true. Actually, I don't do well with nitro fuel. It makes me dizzy. But Caesar told me to make sure you have a good time, so I wanted you to get the full experience of settlement days. Anyway, I'm wagering a Bangboo Ether battery, and if I lose, you can take it and give it to Eos as my apology.
Okay, then.
All right. Then I'll bet a discount coupon for our video store.
God.
All right. I'll go queue up at Steel Tusk. There's going to be a lot of people buying Nitro Fuel today. Take your time looking around. We'll meet up at Steel Tusk later.
Lighter leaves. Okay, that's...
We fighting?
Ready?
Wanna see the red scarf?
I mean, I can already see it, unless if you have someone, something somewhere else.
I'm here, so we're good.
I shall
need something?
I'm at your disposal.
Lots of noise. And admittedly, not a lot of people. And I still can't go across. Moo. Watch out for motorcycles. Hey buddy, wanna come play rock, paper, scissors? Okay, I'll only choose rock, otherwise I lose. Nitro fuel. Y'all are out of nitro fuel.
So sorry, there's so many people buying nitro fuel today. I thought since it's just the first day, people wouldn't go this crazy. So I didn't stock up much. We've run out of nitro fuel. If you're just getting one cup, that's fine, but it's a bit difficult if you want to do a contest. I remember you had
a lot left earlier. Is it all gone already? That's pretty crazy.
Not exactly. It's just a lot of people were worried they wouldn't have enough to drink tonight. So they came here early to buy extra and stock up. If you're looking to do a contest, I can help you keep count. But as for the nitro fuel, you might need to find a way to get some yourselves.
On the way here, actually, I saw some nitro fuel piled up. Why don't we split up and ask around, Proxy? Maybe someone would be willing to share some with us. Sounds good. Also,
why not ask the nearby Outer Ring residents? Many people buy it just to save for the evening, so if you're just borrowing a little, they might agree. I remember seeing a strong-looking fellow and a lass who just bought a lot. They must still be nearby. Why don't you go ask them?
Since when did you guys start hiring no-names? No-name NPCs.
I don't know. Oh, sorry. Am I in your way?
You explained to her that you and Lighter... You explained to her that you and Lighter to do a nitro fuel contest. Translations. So you hope to purchase some nitro fuel from her?
Oh, no. These aren't mine. I'm just helping look after them. Sorry about that. They mentioned they wanted to challenge the undefeated champion of the Sons of Kaladin to a nitro fuel contest later, so they bought a ton.
Actually, I'm planning to compete with Lighter at a nitro fuel contest, too.
You're that undefeated champion's friend, aren't you? He told a bunch of people this afternoon that he... Oh, for fuck's sake. I could only give you 2 bottles of nitro fuel. Well, it wasn't the one who paid for them. Hope you have a great day.
Well, we do a chugging contest. Ooh. Shotgun. First one to finish without spilling wins. Sturdy man.
Hey friend, wanna grab a drink?
Did you mistake me for someone else?
We can get to know each other over a drink. It's not every day you meet someone new, so come on. I have plenty of nitro fuel to share.
I picked a wonderful voice for this guy.
Pretty girl.
You let him know you're looking for looking to challenge Leiter to a nitro fuel contest, so you'd like to buy some drinks from him.
Leiter, that name rings a bell. Isn't he the one with the red scarf from the Sons of Kaladin?
Yep.
Well then, no need to be shy. Take as many as you want. Or, how many do you need? I can bring them right over.
This doesn't seem right, does it?
What's the problem? Just consider it a treat for the most active champion in the Outer Ring. I heard that the red scarf of the Sons of Kaladin have never lost any jewel. To have recruited such a powerful champion, they must be a really impressive gang. Then, the leader of the Sons of Kaladin actually became the new overlord this year. They're definitely not to be taken lightly. I'm scared of them. I'll bring the nitro fuel over to you shortly, so you can head back and wait.
If I get a chance, try my hand against the red scarf too.
I want to fight. Fight.
Fight the red scarf.
I could take him. Yep, I could. Totally.
Leiter, where the hell did you go? Because I was in the two areas that you can go in this area. Okay. Leiter brought back quite a few cases of nitro fuel. The title of the undefeated champion of the Sons of Kaladin seems especially well regarded in Blazewood. Yeah, I wonder why. It's almost like the Sons of Kaladin are kind of the bosses around here, and having an undefeated champion is kind of intimidating.
Wow, you brought back a lot of nitro fuel. Let's kick things off now. I'll keep track for you.
Are you ready? Should we start now? Drinks it all. Leiter drinks the nitro fuel in front of him in one go. Proxy, you're totally in the zone. How about another?
Again! Another!
Leiter drinks another can of nitro fuel, but a little slower this time. Proxy, I seem to have underestimated you.
Another!
Wow, really, Proxy? I'm full. Can you keep going? Let's go for another. After downing a full cup of nitro fuel, Leiter slams his cup on the bar upside down, signaling that he can't go on. Then the nitro fuel lady announces,
Leiter has been defeated!
Proxy, you really caught me off guard. But the challenge is over.
I'll give you what was bet as promised. About accidentally stepping on Eos earlier, please don't be angry anymore.
It's the rule of settlement days. Let's put our grudges behind us.
Just as the challenge with Leiter wraps up, someone approaches.
Finally found you, Red Scarf of the Sons of Kaladin.
Let me catch my breath.
I want to challenge you to a boxing match.
I don't think I know you. Do we have any personal grudges to resolve on settlement days?
Well,
I don't mind sparring with you. I've had too many challenges lately. If there aren't any old grudges to settle, how about we just...
Hold on. I remember now.
You rode your bike past my window before and scared my cat, making it fall from the wardrobe.
Oh, I was finally trying to snap a photo of my super cute cat trying to catch the light on the wall, but you ruined it. I'm gonna bet my cat's photos and challenge you to a boxing match. Ider probably won't accept a challenge like this. He'll accept this challenge. Oh, is that so? Alright, I need to warm up for a bit. I'll bet a can of cat food and accept your challenge.
Alright, Proxy, I'll go warm up.
Is that even a legit reason for a challenge?
I know Settlement Day's challenges are usually not too serious, but does this one count too?
Well, for cat people, their cats are like family. So if they miss out on cute moments for whatever reason, it could be something they'd regret for a long time. So this challenge is valid. I'm ready to accept it and make amends.
Oh my god.
By the way, did you buy the Nitro Fuel raffle ticket?
What's that?
Nitro Fuel raffle ticket? What's that? Sounds fun.
It's just a little extra fun to spice things up. You can buy tickets from the Nitro Fuel vendor and place your bet on who you think will win before the match starts. And by the way, if you bet on me, oh, you'll have all the Nitro Fuel you can drink tonight.
Oh my. And if you lose?
But if you lose, you're gonna cover my Nitro Fuel, right?
There is no if. The champion never loses in the ring.
Oh, really now? Nitro Fuel raffle tickets. Nitro Fuel coupon sizzling hot. Nitro Fuel coupon sizzling hot. Nitro Fuel coupons. Only 500 denis each. Fuel up for your favorite competitor. I'll back lighter. If your chosen contestant wins, the Nitro Fuel coupons you purchase can be redeemed for double the amount of Nitro Fuel. Why wouldn't people choose the undefeated champion? Like, I feel like at that point, you're... Okay, whatever. I'm not... I'll take 5. All set. Here's your Nitro Fuel coupons for him. Make sure you keep them safe. I'm gonna lose them. Are both parties ready? Amidst the cheers, raffle tickets, and Nitro Fuel, everyone seems to be lost in the pure thrill of the challenge, the strength, and the courage, making this day feel like one big celebration. The challengers step up one after another, but Lighter keeps winning. Just as the next challenger is about to enter the ring, a big guy shoves his way forward, pushing others aside, walking right in.
Uh-oh.
So, you're the one sent by the Sons of Caladon, huh? I'm challenging you, and I'm betting this brooch. What's the matter? You scared? I knew the Sons of Caladon didn't deserve the title of Overlord. What a joke.
Let me at him.
Fight me or scram. If you're afraid, say something nice to flatter me. And I, Andreas, might let you off easy.
Does this brooch mean a lot to you?
Of course. Pompey gave it to me himself years ago. It's my badge of honor in the Outer Ring. But whatever. A pup like you won't get it.
To wager something so precious. You must be ready to fight like your life depends on it, yeah?
Huh? It's just a stupid brawl for kids. So stop sounding so dramatic. I'm not losing to you.
Don't wager your honor if you're not serious about this.
Oh, quit stalling. You're just scared.
Let me fight. try to lighten the atmosphere.
How about both of you bet something else? No need to risk something so valuable, right? What do you think, Lighter?
I'll bet my boxing gloves. And if you match me with something similar, then we've got a deal.
Then, I'll match you with my gloves. I'm gonna teach you a lesson either way.
All right.
The winner will wear the gloves on top of their gloves.
The Sons of Caladon accept your challenge.
Andreas might be big, but he doesn't just attack recklessly. He waits for the opportune moment to strike at any weak spots. After a few rounds, Lighter quickly figures out Andreas' fighting style. What started as a pretty even match is now clearly swinging in Lighter's favor.
Not bad, kid. But I bet you learned those moves in the underground fighting pits, didn't you? Did you share any of that dirty money with your dead buddies? Or did you just blow it all, not giving a damn?
Who told you about all that?
No secrets in the world of a big shot like the champion.
I've made peace with my past. Now, I only fight for the Sons of Caladon.
Oh, fighting for the Sons of Caladon, huh? Or using that dirty money to buy yourself a flashy job and a bunch of fangirls in the Outer Ring. You know exactly what I mean. Strutting around with that red scarf, acting all cool like a big shot. Ooh, I'd want a gig like that too.
You realize he can still fight, right?
You and the
That's,
Sons of Caladon.
That means something.
You're just riding on luck. But you know how it goes for those flashy, lucky dogs, huh? They bite the dust and end up 6 feet under in the Outer Ring.
Let me fight as Lighter. Although Andreas has been knocked down, he seems to be trying to provoke Lighter on purpose with his words. Lighter walks up to Andreas, looking like he's about to finish him off. Even the referee is ready to step in. But to everyone's surprise, Lighter squats down, taps Andreas' glove, then grabs his sunglasses from the side and puts them back on.
You don't recognize the new Overlord, so taking your bet doesn't mean anything. I'll give you 3 days. If you want a rematch,
let me
game.
Fight as Lighter
any
in that
time,
rematch.
As many times
Please.
As you want. Oh, hey, the sun's about to set. Who's up next?
The ring returns to its previous relaxed atmosphere, and Lighter continues to win his matches all the way until sunset. After defeating the last challenger, Lighter takes off his gloves and walks away from the crowd.
Didn't think you'd stick around till the end, Proxy.
I bet I bought those raffle tickets.
Of course. I bought those Nitro Fuel raffle tickets, didn't I?
So, did you bet everything on me? Cause I've worked hard to keep my promise and get you all that Nitro Fuel, you know?
Oh, you're so sweet. I could take you.
Who else would I bet on? But seriously, how am I ever gonna finish all this Nitro Fuel?
Come on, I went all out to win this for you, so at least enjoy yourself tonight. I promise I won't say a word to your sibling.
Oh. Oh. I mean, he already has a harem going. I will happily take another harem. That is. Oh god, that line is. You wanna join me?
Wanna join me later?
I've got something I need to check on first. I'll be back later. Go ahead and grab your drinks from Bernice. I'll catch up if I finish early.
With that, Lighter leaves. Lighter's punches are as I'll beat him one day. Where's Lighter, our champion? I can't talk to you, Piper. Why are you here then?
Wow, nobody.
Did you close up shop? Hey, Proxy. Are you here to get some nitro fuel as well? Later said I could redeem my coupons with you. No problem. Let's see.
Wow, you're a real one.
All of these are in support of lighter. So much nitro fuel. If you drink them all, the other proxy will probably get upset, right? How about you sell me some of this nitro fuel? I'll pay you in Denny's at the regular price. What do you think?
Really?
Bernice is such a great person, right? Bernice is such a great person. You can't say that back. You can't say that. Back in the early days, us members of the Sons of Kaladin were even more out there than we are now. Really? Take Lighter, for example. Big Daddy suddenly arrived one day with Lighter in tow. And at first, Lighter hardly ever spoke to us or ate with me. Oh, and back then, he would even refuse the nitro fuel drinks I mixed for him. Although, as a champion, he really is perfect. But trying to interact with him was a real headache. What exactly is a champion? Generally speaking, before different gangs come into conflict, there's usually a testing of waters. And at that point, both sides will send someone to take the lead. If this person wins, it boosts morale and intimidates the opponent. So there's an unwritten rule that the champion of each gang is always the strongest fighter in that team. Although the champions of each gang have slightly different personalities, they're usually the flashy, attention-grabbing types. The Sons of Kaladin. The champion of the Sons of Kaladin is Lighter. He always wears a red scarf when he wins. So over time, people tend to refer to him as the Red Scarf of the Sons of Kaladin. I said so much I almost forgot. Here's the Denny's I earned from Sunny Nitro Fuel. Hold on to these and have fun! Also, if you see Lighter, tell him Big Daddy is looking for him. Oh, Lighter. Meeting off in a secluded area, huh? Are we gonna cross that street? From a distance, you see Lighter standing alone. His silhouette is hard to make out in the dark, but that red scarf of his stands out.
What brings you here, Proxy?
Big Daddy's apparently looking for you.
Bernice asked me to pass on a message when I was grabbing the nitro fuel. She said Big Daddy wants to see you.
Oh, sure. I'll be back in a minute. I've got something to tell Big Daddy, too. Remember Andreas? I had a feeling something was off, so I came here to keep an eye on him. I saw him answering a phone call, arguing with someone. And then he mentioned something about the Hollow. I'm gonna go back and do some digging on this Andreas guy.
Didn't know you're so observant, Lighter.
I always thought you're the red scarf who steals all the spotlight. I didn't think you'd be watching what's going on behind the scenes.
It's because Andreas brought up some things from my past. So yeah, I'm being more cautious. I'm pretty sure we've never crossed paths before. And I've never talked about my shady past since I came to the Outer Ring. It can't just be a coincidence that he knows about it.
Looks like you've had a troubled past, Lighter.
So it's all true. I had no idea that you'd been through so much, Lighter.
Yeah, If it weren't for my past, I wouldn't be wearing these sunglasses all the time. Sure, I get lightheaded around blood, but it's mainly because of a bad eye injury I got in an underground fight. My injury was pretty severe. I had to keep my eyes covered and live in the dark for a while. Even though it's all healed now, if I don't keep it shaded, it feels like opening up old wounds again. And, never mind. Anyway, I hope you don't mind me always wearing sunglasses when we talk.
It doesn't bother me.
Ah, I always thought you were just trying to look cool. But don't worry, I'm totally used to it.
You're funny, Proxy.
How did you become the Red Scarf, Lighter?
By the way, why did you become the Red Scarf?
Because Big Daddy paid off all my debts, and I needed to repay his kindness. Plus, Red Scarf sounds pretty cool, don't you think?
Lighter says that in a lighthearted tone, but then he goes quiet, gazing at the crowd like he's lost in thought. Before he can say anything else, his phone buzzes with an influx of messages.
It's Piper. Some guys I beat today are at Steel Tusk. They're up for a Nitro Field challenge. I'm gonna talk to Big Daddy about Andreas, and then go kick some butt. Oh, and Piper wanted me to tell you that the other proxy has arrived in Blazewood, too.
God damn.
You two should crash here tonight. The Sons of Caladon will make sure you're well taken care of.
Where are all the people? There are no people. There are all the people. This town is very small. Also, I like how they can... Okay, whatever. Ooh. Are you a friend of that Lighter guy? Makes sense for the friend of young punks to be a young punk too. Hey bro, Bill, did you have fun today? Lighter's arena fight. You recount for Weiss the affairs of the day, including the part when Andreas was winding Lighter up. Sounds like apart from a few minor hiccups, everything went well. You must be tired after today. How about we talk more tomorrow? Ugh, fine.
Okay.
Not off this time. Actually, hold on. Do 479. Yay! So literally these are all, they're all the same. Like, what? Okay, whatever. Okay, open. Grab a thing. Wakey wakey.
The joy that this delicious composition brings is truly what a perfect mix.
Oh my fucking god, game.
What flavor of music would you like to try today? I'll be waiting.
Wait.
For
oh my god. Adrian.
Touch my tail? We fighting? Ready?
Wanna see the red scarf?
Actually, physical damage. Okay.
Good enough.
Want to see the red scarf?
Go ahead and close that. Oh, right, coffee. Do-do-do-do-do. Spider's thing has done things. God, I'm an idiot. Okay, Asian stories. Young Sun Champion. Begin? We're about to enter immersive storytelling. We can't do anything else. Should you be more energized than... Should you be more energized the more nitrophil you drink? I just don't get how you can slump over steel tusk like that. I don't have the muscles to move yet. Wake up! Nope. Completely out. Stone cold. Proxy, have you seen Lighter? Nope. What's up?
I was gonna ask Lighter to grab today's raffle ticket for me, but I couldn't find him anywhere this morning. I thought you were out partying all night.
I didn't expect you to be up so early, Proxy.
Do you think Lighter's in trouble? It is settlement days after all.
Nah, don't worry about it. Lighter goes off by himself all the time. Nobody really knows what he's up to. Big Daddy never said anything about it, so I'm sure he's not getting into any trouble.
Well, speaking of Big Daddy,
maybe he'll be back in the afternoon. Well, little old me needs to go catch some ZZZs. If you see Lighter, tell him to drag away those guys who passed out by Steel Tusk, will ya?
Piper walks off.
Belle, you said that Lighter was looking into Andreas yesterday, and he mentioned the Hollow, right? Should we go check it out, just to be safe?
Probably.
I know Lighter isn't the reckless type, but he really looked out for me yesterday, so I can't just leave him alone. Let's check inside the Hollow and look for him.
Okay. Trial use.
I'm here, so we're good.
You have my complete support.
Touch my tail.
Yukasurian, ready and
we fighting? Take me.
Awaiting further instruction.
A new case to solve.
Time for some heart. How can I?
Ready for
ready and wait.
Only the brave will win.
That's me.
Okay, let's get ready.
Let's go.
After entering the Hollow, you quickly find Lighter's location using Fairy Scan. You meet up with Lighter and explain why you came looking for him.
Sorry for worrying you, Proxy. I usually handle these things solo. No one really knows or cares, except for Big Daddy. Last night, I did some digging and found out that Andreas was probably goaded on by an old rival gang. That's why he showed up during settlement days, looking for trouble. Earlier today, I spotted some shady new faces around Blazewood. I figured they're probably connected to Andreas and our old rivals, so I followed them into the Hollow.
What happened?
What happened?
Simply put, they're trying to use settlement days under Caesar's supervision as a chance to settle their beef and bring down the Sons of Caladon. They're setting up an ambush around Blazewood. They plan to strike tomorrow and start a full-blown fight. As you know, the town is now packed with regular people and other gangs. If the Sons of Caladon can't handle this right, people will lose their trust in us. I was hoping to figure out their route and take care of them before they could do anything, but they went poof and vanished.
It's too dangerous. Take me with you.
It's too dangerous for you to do this alone, Lighter.
Yeah, but during settlement days, everyone's got their own roles to play. Honestly, I didn't want to drag you into these Outer Ring disputes, Proxy. But I'm glad you're here, or I would be stuck with no clues.
Running off solo to play hero is a bad idea.
Running off solo to play the hero is a bad idea.
Well, could I ask the esteemed Phaethon to lead the way now?
Hail ye.
You got it. Leave it to me.
Gains morale, any squad member consumes. Morale, which is 80, help watch quick assist.
Warning, there are a few enemies ahead.
What's your honor really worth?
Or you get...
There it is.
It's the emblem of our old enemy's gang. Let's go after them.
Please continue onwards.
Make way for the undefeated champion!
Boom, boom.
Speculation. The enemy is behind the debris.
Okay. We push through.
Ooh.
You went back on your word! That's not how things work in the Outer Ring! Pompey would never stand for this!
We said from the start we'd teach the Sons of Caladon a lesson, and you were all in for it!
But you never said anything about putting the regular folks and other gangs in danger!
You're just like the former Overlord. That sentimental old loser. He got backstabbed by his right hand. What a fool.
Backstabbed by his right hand? Didn't you say it was the Sons of Caladon that were behind it?
Oh, did I say that? When you asked about Pompey's death, all I said was, why did you ask the Sons of Caladon instead?
You? You're all...
Go on, keep shouting! Soon you'll reunite with that good-for-nothing old boss of yours!
This is the Outer Ring, where the strong reign and the weak fall.
All right.
It's Andreas. Turns out he really was tricked by them. Proxy, you better hurry.
I really want
to dodge.
Courage is power! Knowledge is too!
Caesar, how much knowledge do you actually have?
Not even close! There's more to battle! The glory!
There it is!
I'll take you.
Okay.
My head's still on. I'm still alive!
By settlement day's rules, you face your challenges head on, not sneaking around and stabbing people in the back.
Screw your rules or whatever. Tomorrow, those losers in Blazewood and the Sons of Caladon will meet their end!
Rival minions back off and throw smoke bombs, disappearing into the haze.
No need to chase them, Proxy. Nailing a few minions won't change much. Their main force isn't around here. If only we knew which direction they'd be coming from tomorrow.
Even if you did, what difference would it make? The Sons of Caladon will be out in full force tomorrow. With all the gangs around, some of them might try to pull something. Who knows? The Outer Ring plays by its own rules. It's all survival of the fittest. And backstabbers are a dime a dozen. Even Pompeii didn't make it. And neither will your new overlord.
So, you know their plan?
Did you hear anything I just said? If I hadn't misunderstood you guys, I wouldn't even bother explaining all this.
I challenge you.
Huh? You can just punch me if you're pissed. Now that I know you're not tied to Pompey's death, I'm not interested in wasting my time on you guys.
If you lose, you tell us everything you know. If you win, well, I'll tell you the last words of the late Overlord.
You know Pompey's last words?
So, will you accept my
what
challenge?
What were the last words? I don't think many of us know.
Out of my way!
Andreas! The challenge isn't over yet.
You don't have to tell me! Take that!
Nope.
Let me show you how it's done.
Take them all! Blazing flame! Together! Watch it!
I'm unstoppable!
There's no retreat now. Target confirmed.
Watch and learn.
An opening. Let's roll.
Gotcha now.
Okay. After losing to Leiter, Andreas follows the rules and spills everything he knows. Then, with a mix of relief and self-deprecation, he speaks up.
Whew, man. It's hard not to envy you. You're so young, but you've already reached the top so easily. Winning effortlessly with style. And being the one everyone looks up to. I gotta admit, you're a better fit for the Outer Ring than I ever was.
Let me ask you something. What would you do if you found out someone was plotting against Cinder Lake, and you had no backup?
What kind of question is that? Of course I defend Cinder Lake with my life. No second thoughts about it. What's so funny? This isn't just talk. Cinder Lake is the pride of the Outer Ring. I'd risk everything to protect it.
And welcome to the thought process of the Sons of Kaladin and Blazewood. Almost instinctively, Andreas touches his chest, his hand over the brooch from the late Overlord, a token he kept close beneath his armor.
You must protect Cinder Lake.
Nothing. I'm not doubting you. Pompey would be glad to hear your steadfast response.
Huh? What do you mean?
It's not about who's a better fit for the Outer Ring. You've been here longer than I have, and your ties to this land are deeper than mine. I might have the upper hand in Aspar now, but who knows who will win next time. It's anyone's game. I'm always down for a rematch, but on one condition. If you're not prepared to put your life on the line, don't bet something you see as your highest honor so easily.
Andreas fist bumps Leiter with a mix of frustration, respect, and admiration. After this, their grudge is finally settled. We still didn't learn their plan, did we? Or like where that he didn't. Okay. You know what? Never mind.
Thanks for today, Proxy. Lucky you were there to guide me. Otherwise, I wouldn't have learned about their plan.
About tomorrow.
Are you planning to handle this on your own tomorrow, Leiter?
Well, like those guys said, if the Sons of Kaladin go all out on the last day of settlement days, it'll look like the new Overlord doesn't really command respect from the other gangs. And the folks in Blazewood might worry that the Sons of Kaladon's old enemies will keep coming back to cause trouble. So, I think it's best if I handle this on my own.
Coming with you.
When Big Daddy pulled me out of the underground fights, we agreed I'd deal with any old grudges and enemies from Kaladon's past.
Old enemies of Kaladin.
Dealing with old enemies? I didn't know you had to do all that.
The Sons of Kaladin are still growing, and a lot of gangs in the Outer Ring are eyeing this new faction full of Kaladon's legacy. Big Daddy wants Caesar to be a fair leader, and not to follow in her father's footsteps. So, there are some things only I can handle.
Her father's footsteps? No one knows about all the stuff you're doing.
Are you doing this for the Sons of Kaladin to pay back Big Daddy? No one in the Sons of Kaladin knows what you're doing for them.
You're making it sound way too serious, Proxy. I'm getting paid, so I've got to do a good job, right?
I'll lead the way tomorrow.
Well, at least let me guide you through the Hollow tomorrow. Don't be so quick to turn down my offer. After all, I'm a proxy, and it's my job to ensure my clients get back safely. I can't afford to lose such an important client like the Sons of Kaladin.
Looks like I'll have to bring my A-game tomorrow. Can't let the red scarf of the Sons of Kaladin embarrass himself in front of you. See you tomorrow, Proxy.
Party's over, apparently. Belle, don't force yourself. If it's not safe, then we can get some extra help beforehand. Trust in Leiter. Alright. But can I just say in advance that if things go south tomorrow, I am definitely calling backup. Today's been really busy, so let's get some rest so we're fresh and ready to face tomorrow. I'll go recharge and gather my strength too. I figured out what the route is. Though, there's a few more people than I expected. But it's still manageable. Proxy, today might be a bit risky. If you...
I'm just a guide, and Eos will be hiding mostly, so don't worry about us.
I just don't want to lose another...
Never mind. They're gathering to cross the Hollow now. We should intercept them before they cause any trouble in Blazewood.
Sure.
Sure thing. I'll get you the shortest route through the hollow.
And, thanks, Proxy.
Alrighty, thanking me.
Did I miss something? We're just getting started, but you're already thanking me?
No, just felt like saying thanks.
No need to say it twice.
Don't jinx it. In movies, when someone says stuff like that, things always go south.
Got it. I won't say it again, but just know I mean it. Let's head out when you're ready.
Okay.
Proxy, we're running out of time. We have to stop those guys in the hall. I'm relying on you to find the shortest route. What a drag. Take the shortest route, and I'll handle any enemies along the way. Ooh, that was close. I almost stepped on Eos's foot just now.
Ooh.
I'd be stuck carrying Eos if I did.
Oh, no, you don't.
Target enemy has entered the fissure.
The main force should be over there. By the way, Proxy, thanks for guiding me.
Yeah, good.
Hey, you there! Beat it! Get out of the way, we're in a hurry!
Sorry, but I can't let you pass.
Whoa, hold up! Red scarf and sunglasses? You're the Red Scarf from the Sons of Caladon!
Huh? The Sons of Caladon really think one guy can stop us?
If you've got a problem with the Sons of Caladon, settle it fair and square. Don't go causing trouble in Blazewood.
Fair and square! Since when does the Outer Ring care about fair play? I must have missed the memo. In a place like this, it's all about who's got more muscle. Only the winner gets to decide what's fair.
The Outer Ring doesn't need any more pointless fights. Caladon, that's all history now. Today's the last day of settlement days. By the rules, if you've got beef, challenge us properly. So, what's it gonna be?
Rules? You guys playing house or something?
Enough talk. Mm. Take this!
I, Lighter, of the Sons of Caladon, am here to issue a challenge to all of you.
All of us? What are you putting up?
Scarf?
I bet. My red scarf.
Fine. We'll stake our bad blood with the Sons of Caladon. Don't quit right away.
Challenge accepted. I'll take on all of you.
so bring it.
Please tell me I get to fight a bunch of guys off. Honestly, the 2D brawler for this, I kind of like. Kind of wish the camera angle were
I fight my honor!
Higher up to give that better action up to you, but you know what? This is still good. Push that all through the butt line.
Out of my way!
You really think you can take on all of us?
To deal with you, fists are more than enough.
Watch him, man!
Gosh, I knew enemies to take this time.
Make way for the undefeated champion!
Hope you your fist castles. Lighter's final blow, the fight is over. Let me get you a water and a towel. If I don't have any, you can just use Eos as the towel. Go ahead, use Eos as the towel.
I, Lighter of the Sons of Caledon, have completed the challenge as promised. The Red Scarf isn't something you can take from us. By the rules of settlement days, all your old debts with Caledon are settled here and now.
Only one person witnessed this.
I did it. Beat every last one of them. No cheers for the champion?
Perhaps no one else will ever know about this victory. But at least for now, letting the sunset linger a bit longer, and let the faint applause last a bit more. Here's to a victory against all odds, to the unsung champion.
Oh, I'm so tired. Gotta take a breather here. You're in no rush to take Eos back, right?
There's not much I can do regardless.
Even if I was in a rush, there's not much I can do about it, right?
Well, I could always lower the seat and Eos can hop on my bike and drive me back.
Still cracking jokes, Lighter.
Still cracking jokes, Lighter? Sounds like you're not that tired. Maybe you should join me on another commission.
No. I'm seriously wiped out. Please, give me a break.
Not gonna lie, that was pretty intense.
Not gonna lie, seeing so many of them today was pretty scary. Wait a minute. You thanked me before we went into the Hollow. Were you planning on doing something reckless then?
Oh.
Nah, I wouldn't call it reckless.
Oh.
I wouldn't be betting this red scarf if I wasn't ready to put my life on the line.
Why would you go that far, Lighter?
Why would you go that far, Lighter?
Remember what Andreas brought up the other day, Proxy? It's all part of my past.
Lighter takes off his sunglasses. The sunset isn't glaring, but he lowers his gaze, seeming a bit uncomfortable.
Because of my poor judgment, my mercenary companions lost their lives. I was filled with regret, but I knew that even giving up my own life wouldn't change anything. I took out a huge loan to support their families. Those were some tough times. Then, the debt collectors threw me into an underground fighting ring to work off what I owed. I didn't have anywhere else to go, or any other options, so I just went along with it. I was like a zombie those days, just seeing one opponent after another under the spotlight, with nothing but cheers and curses ringing in my ears. After being there for a while, I became scared to look anyone in the eye. I was afraid of what I'd see staring back at me. And then, Big Daddy paid off my debts, pulled me out of that place, and handed me this red scarf. He called me a high-profile fighter, saying I rarely lost. He said he wanted me to keep winning for the Sons of Caladon. When I joined the Sons of Caladon, I thought it was just another boxing show. But over time, I genuinely wanted to protect everyone because I can't stand losing any more friends. I know this might sound a little arrogant, but as long as I keep winning, other gangs will show respect and fear for the Sons of Caladon whenever they see me. This red scarf isn't just a sign of victory. It's a warning to anyone who wants to cause trouble. As long as I breathe, I'll never tarnish the honor of the Sons of Caladon.
Lighter lowers his head and touches the red scarf carefully. The warm sunlight is about to dip below the desert horizon, casting layers of light that stretch across the skyline, shifting between hazy and clear. In this moment, extended by the fading light, Lighter finally seems to adjust to the shifting shadows. He lifts his head.
I have my people, and a home I want to protect. I'm sorry for making you worry. But thank you. I'm glad that besides this red scarf, you've also gotten to witness my small moment of glory.
By the time Lighter gets back to Blazewood, the night has fully settled in.
I handed Eos over to the other proxy. Thankfully, it didn't get scratched or dinged up. Otherwise, the other proxy would have been pretty pissed.
You've got a lot on your plate.
And what about me getting pissed? I can be pretty scary when I'm mad, you know.
Well, settlement days are finally over. These 3 days really flew by.
Uh-huh. You're terrible at changing topics, Lighter.
You're terrible at changing topics, Lighter.
Yeah, well, I never know how to react when my friends are upset.
Well, I'll let it slide this time.
Just kidding. I'm not angry.
Whew. It's getting late. Are you heading back to 6th Street, Proxy? Oh, I'm not trying to shoo you away or anything. Just saying, if you're planning to come back and visit the Outer Ring again, give me a heads up next time. I'll pick you up from the video store. Now that I think about it, it's always been Eels that's been riding with me. But next time, I want you to see our sunset with your own eyes.
Yes, please.
Okay, it's legitimately like this. What? I expect to see some fanfic of Belle and Leiter.
Belle, great job today. Great job. Today's the last day of celebration, so let's relax and have some fun. I just met with Caesar and she said they prepared tons of fancy food tonight with more nitro fuel than they can drink. Let's keep eating till we burst.
This out after.
Okay. Please select.
Oh.
Increases. Okay.
Let's go. I still don't understand stuff's shit. Basic tackle.
Launch two anti-corruption level is increased. Unleash a series of slashes in front.
That is actually really loud.
If you need help, call me anytime. If you need help, okay. Call me anytime.
What done?
Criminal.
Okay.
A mission? Take me along.
You have... Let's...
If you need help, call me anytime.
Wanna go...
You have...
Let's fire it up.
Dukashirayana, you have my complete support. Dukash, ready and waiting.
Wanna see the red scarf?
I shall follow...
I'm...
Await... You have... Dukashirayanagi, awaiting orders.
Save.
My blade is at the ready.
You know what? Let's try this stupid default configuration again. Don't know why, but...
Simple.
Not bad, huh? Death in position. You may remain silent.
Waste of time. Secure the perimeter, please.
Enemy target discovered. Guardian Mark 3.
Mark 3, huh? Sorry, Harry, can't really hear you.
Resistance is futile.
Waste of time. It's pointless for this.
Turn over, and you leave!
Hello.
Don't be careless.
Hungry? Mind and body.
Okay. Anomaly is a weird attack combo, but I think I'm slowly getting used to it.
A mission? Take me along!
Wanna hit?
Ready and wait.
We fighting? Take me! Only the brave will win. That's me!
Active skill damage after active skill. Try this. Because honestly, Seth's cool and all of it. He's weird. I don't necessarily like the.
Let me at him.
This team feels more at home. Please tell me the next one is not going to be the twins. Cause I have trouble with the twins.
If you need help, call me.
We fighting? Take me. Only the brave. Okay, let's get ready.
Lagol.
Roger. Let me at him.
That's a heater.
This ends here. Resistance to heat iron.
Taking off for a bit.
This party is just getting started!
Press the attack!
So why was the audio super loud there? I'm assuming I can buy everything. Yeah, okay. This, however, contains... Oh, wait, this is all... Okay, never mind. I'm dumb. Go to lighter. Hard mode dual, huh. Must converse. Pissed gun, okay.
Ready? You only the brave will win.
That's me.
Finish you. I don't know why I was leveling up Anton. I don't use him.
It's our
awaiting further
Come on.
So, did you call me?
Ready for cup. Nothing to feed.
I shall
need some. Nothing.
I match you.
Also,
let
rip
me finish
her.
My cup of hot water.
She does not get used. Okay. I don't know.
Go to Officer Meow Meow.
Overlord, you can't just ignore this. Of course I can. Boss.
Proxy, you're finally here.
do me a favor and talk some sense into Caesar.
Oh no, what is she doing?
You're supposed to be the proxy Caesar asked for?
And who is this?
What's going on? Who is this? And what's with the scary tone?
My bad, proxy. This guy is from one of the biker gangs in the League. Caesar is the leader of the Motor League now, so she's got some official business to deal with. Just talk to the proxy directly. If you're going into the Hollow to sort things out, you're gonna need a proxy.
It rained heavily that day. There were 100 of them. No, maybe even more. And me? All I had was a delivery truck, my two fists, and the pride of a biker. Badger's respite was right behind me. The word retreat doesn't exist in a biker's vocabulary. There's only battle. And battle we did.
Mm-hmm.
All it took was one punch. Just one punch.
Okay. You scared off 100 bandits all by yourself?
You scared off 100 bandits all by yourself?
I got slammed to the ground. Then with one kick, I was sent rolling 30 meters away.
Dude, what's with the heroic expression?
Oh, thank you, Lighter, for saying what I was thinking. You sound proud. You sound a little too proud for getting your ass kicked.
So you want the Overlord to deal with the gang.
So, your crew sent you to ask the Sons of Caladon for help, hoping the Overlord will step in and take out those gangsters in the Hollow?
There's no way we can let those f***ing gangsters get away with this! They acted like I was nothing. I mean, like the entire Motor League was nothing! Caesar, you're the new Overlord. You won't let them get away with this, right?
Of course not.
Caesar, don't be fooled.
Look, if those Hollow gangsters are messing with the League's convoys, I can't just sit back and do nothing.
That's the determination of a real Overlord. We made the right choice in following you. Proxy, don't forget to film Caesar's heroic moment while she deals with those f***ed. I want the entire gang to see what a real biker gang looks like.
There's no need for Caesar to get involved. I can take care of it.
Huh? But he's begging me to go. How could I not step in?
Boss, as the leader of the Sons of Caladon and the Overlord of the Motor League, delegating tasks to your crew is also part of the job. Let me take care of it.
Handing this off to my subordinates? Would that make me look less like an Overlord? What do you think, Proxy?
I think there's something fishy about this loudmouth. He keeps trying to egg Caesar on.
Lighter and I will go check things out first.
Caesar, Lighter is right. Why not let us go check things out first? If we run into trouble, then you can step in. What do you think?
If you say so. All right.
Caesar, you're not going to help handle this personally? They've got the numbers on their side.
You haven't seen what Lighter can do.
Hey! Are you disrespecting the red scarf of the Sons of Caladon?
Oh, chill, boss. No need to flex.
Now he says no need to flex.
What do you mean, no need to flex? You're totally flexing.
Proxy, I'll have to trouble you again.
The Overlord's convoy responsibilities are weighty.
Yeah. The boss expanded the business without permission. Should I ask Caesar for more money? Just kidding. I'm not going to make a fuss today.
The Hollow Gang typically don't mess with the Alliance's convoys. However, the recent leadership changes may have led some gangs to think they have an opportunity, prompting them to do something foolish. Before Lighter cuts in, could finish, a familiar voice cuts in.
Who's doing something foolish? Lighter?
Can I watch?
Can I film? Can I sell the footage to the proxy and split the earnings? Okay, got it. Bernice is the one that will hold the camera. Is it a comedy or an action flick, Proxy? Which one sells better in your store? Probably an action flick. Bernice, have you finished your new fuel formula? Not at all. Piper looks eagerly... Piper looks eagerly waiting for the new recipe. There should be a comma there. This anticipation is overwhelming. No one can perform well when being watched from behind. So I slipped out to find some inspiration. Hey, since Proxy is here too, are you all going to the Hollow? Just handling a small task. Is it another secret task of Lighter's? Not a secret one this time. Caesar knows too. Should we bring Bernice along? Proxy? I'll put you as the co-author of my new fuel... recipe. Wait, I haven't agreed yet. The loudmouth says there are a lot of enemies. How about this, Bernice? You take care of the proxy's bang boo, and when needed, I'll call you for help. Deal? No problem, no problem. Let me grab the handheld camera. Yes, we'll keep recording visual data. No, we don't need that, right? No, we don't need that, right? Dob battle. Introduction. Champion, yada yada. Master, introduce you to special play.
Let's fire it up!
Be stronger against the strong. Don't look at the audience. Oh my god. Switch character to summon your support. Unleash coordinated attack. This will not interrupt your character's action. 8-second cooldown.
Is this what that loudmouth meant by they've got the numbers? There sure are a lot of them. Too bad they're all so weak.
Okay.
Gotcha! Watch and learn!
Hey, game. Any particular reason why you are so fucking loud? Also, I kind of wish D-pad would work on this, but it's on. He has less removable, but whatever.
Watch out!
Okay. Complete.
Proxy, something feels off.
Light are so strong.
I've dealt with gangs from the Outer Ring. This group of thugs doesn't even rank among the top. At this level, how dare they stir up trouble during the Overlord's transfer?
Does Lighter think they're still hiding their strength?
It's still too early to tell what the situation is. So, I plan to press that loudmouth a bit more to see if I can find out anything else. The townspeople told me that loudmouth said the convoy had an urgent job and left early. I asked Big Daddy to contact the leader of that convoy, but it turns out they had a job to run and they went into the hollow. Can't reach them now. The information checks out.
Is Lighter still suspicious about this?
Yeah, that was just a hunch. There are two more leads we can dig into if we want to keep investigating. First is the loudmouth's intent. When he came for help, he kept pushing for Caesar to take action. If Caesar is their real target, having Caesar show up might force them to reveal their hand. Second is the refinery. I took a look when we passed by today. Those bandits scattered quickly and seemed unusually familiar with the refinery's path. If that's their base, there should be some clues left behind. Proxy, want to join me for another round tomorrow?
Is this a counter move?
Hard to say. Depends on whether my guess is right. Tomorrow, I'll handle the situation. Caesar, stick to the same strategy you and Bernice used today. I get what you mean with the boss's personality getting her to stay in the rear for support.
I'll convince her.
True, if it's you, Caesar should listen. Then let's meet here tomorrow. I'm counting on you, Proxy.
While locking in a time to meet with Lighter tomorrow, you ask what Bernice is up to. After all, you still have to pass the video Eos captured to her. Lighter blocks you without a word. He doesn't think that wearing sunglasses can hide his embarrassment, does he? He doesn't even budge when you offer to split his rent with him.
All you can do is take your battle trophy, red scarf, and rest up.
Nights in the Outer Ring seem to be much quieter than in the city.
It's a new day.
Go catch up with Lighter and help persuade Caesar.
Okay, Caesar, how about you go on a date with Weiss, and we'll be good.
Boss, that's pretty much what happened yesterday.
So, that loudmouth is a liar?
Not necessarily. Just some doubts. Let's not overthink it. He said all that yesterday just to provoke...
Let's not overthink it. He said all that yesterday just to provoke me into action. Well, then I'll act.
If someone wants to challenge me, the new Overlord, I'm not gonna hide. You think I'd be afraid of an ambush?
Boss, if it's a proper challenge, the bigger the spectacle, the better. Otherwise, what's the point of the challenge?
Like I said earlier, boss, if you come with me,
to the refinery today. Just show your face, engage the reaction. After that, leave the rest to me. Proxy, why do I feel like Leiter is making me sound like... bait for fishing? Proxy, are you really here to help me? But Leiter does have a point. Caesar, you're definitely strong. But isn't Pompey strong too? Wait. Hold on, are you implying I'm Lucius now? Alright, Proxy, I get what you're saying. I'll stay back with your bang boo to support Leiter. Does that sound good enough? I never thought I'd want to use the word considerate to describe Caesar. A king must understand people's hearts, of course. Is that a quote from some movie? Actually, sounds pretty reasonable. Anyway, since Caesar agrees with the plan, once Proxy is ready, we'll set off. Let's head back to check out that refinery. Got the battle.
Only the brick.
Wanna go?
We fighting? Take me.
After defeating 5 enemies, we'll enter a frenzy state. 10 seconds every 3 enemies. Extends the state. Defeating normal enemies advances. Theme mechanics increase. Okay.
Wow, that's a lot of guys. But man, they're really weak. Seriously?
Excellent.
Ambush
me.
Would
you like
these
guys? Some epic background music for him?
Is this supposed to be a joke?
Proxy, do you see something over there? Is that a map?
Excellent. Would you like me to play some epic background music for him?
And do -2 decibels because that looks like it's getting really loud. Like redlining loud. This map looks familiar. Wait, isn't this the new route assigned by the Convoy Alliance? Even though it's not the same base map as Loopy's. God, Lucy's. Even though it's not the same base map as Lucy's, I can still recognize it. Not just that, boss. Look. This stretch of road, marked in red, where Loudmouth said they were ambushed. The g- gang harassing the convoy is real? Now it seems much more likely. If the gang raiding the Alliance's convoy was just fake intel to lure Caesar to the refinery, this map wouldn't even be necessary. Yeah, and I remember the terrain near this stretch is quite complicated, making it ideal for an ambush. No, it does not solve the case. Almost. We'll give those thugs a good beating today. We gave those thugs a good beating today. I doubt they'll mess with the Alliance convoy anytime soon. Lighter, let's check it out. Let's check with Piper again on the latest transport schedule for that route.
Boss, are you worried?
That's right. If they're using a map, that means they need to convey information. Besides, I have a feeling the refinery crew was too weak. But what if it's because their skilled members were stationed somewhere else?
Got it, boss. I'll find Piper and check the route again. Check that road again.
Proxy, looks like you're not done for... You're not done for the day yet. You don't mind, right?
As long as I get paid, I don't mind.
Alright, I'll call Piper tomorrow, and we'll meet at the usual spot in Blazewood.
Master, schedule has been updated.
Perfect timing, Proxy. Piper, explain everything together.
Sure. It's not too complicated. The route you asked about, Lighter, is indeed the one the Convoy Alliance uses. But since it passes through the Hollow, unless it's an urgent delivery or Hollow supplies, we don't usually take that route. There haven't been any shipments scheduled to pass through there for a week. For a week before or after. At least, none from the Convoy Alliance. Why the frown, Lighter? In that case, we don't need to drag the proxy along. I could just... go back and sleep a little longer.
Huh? Not going?
Weren't we supposed to make a scene in the Hollow? And there are unlimited free targets, too.
No one has said that. No one has ever said that.
I've got a new fuel formula that needs testing. Perfect for evaluating burn efficiency in action.
Piper, you need the new fuel formula to be put into production, right?
Am I the second author of that formula?
That's right, that's the one.
But this is Lighter's mission, right? Lighter has the final say.
Lighter promised Caesar that he would investigate, right?
Let's go finish what we started.
Yay!
In a couple days, I'll go to Badger's Respite and you can bring some old magazines.
Oh?
Deal. No backing out.
Go to battle.
We fighting?
Let's fire it up!
Ah,
play some epic background music for him?
No, he makes a good point.
Suggestion. You should maintain a good relationship with this agent.
I'll maintain a good relationship with him. Real good.
These gangsters, they seem different from yesterday. Let's talk about this when we get back, Proxy.
He makes a good point. Suggestion, you should maintain a good relationship with this agent.
Ow.
He makes a good point. Suggestion, you should maintain a good relationship with this agent.
Yes.
He makes a good
place. Okay. Complete. Did you notice, Proxy? Not the same group. What did Leiter mumble while fighting? Was it that the highway gang isn't the same group you investigated before?
Exactly. Although typical gangs are just a bunch of ruffians, different gangs will have different styles. Common weapons used, slogans to rally their comrades, whether they prefer hit and run tactics or overwhelming numbers. We've previously guessed that the Refinery Gang sent some people here to stake out this highway. But from the moment I engaged today, I felt something was off. This highway gang is much more arrogant than those timid ones from the refinery. They don't seem like they're coming from the same group at all.
Then why was the map we found at the refinery marked with the location of this highway? So the two sides actually have no connection? Are we the good guys with a knack for showing up where bandits are? It seems I really do have that kind of knack.
Seriously, no need to overthink it. The matters of the Outer Ring aren't that mystical. It's all about profit. It's probably just that two groups have their eyes on this highway at the same time. And the reason we are led to the refinery is likely that we were seen as a tool to eliminate competition.
Oh! So that's how it is! Leiter seems very familiar with such matters, figuring it out so quickly.
Just seen it too many times.
Huh. I didn't expect that we would find that map at the refinery. And these bandits led the Sons of Caladan right into their territory. Did I get it right?
So far, that seems to be the case. Now the question is, why has this group suddenly attracted the attention of two gangs?
Piper, you mean that recently there haven't been any convoys from the Alliance passing through here, right? That's right, I won't mistake anything regarding freight.
No matter what they're after, they probably haven't gotten their hands on it yet. Otherwise, we would have struck out today. That said, I remember there's an abandoned side road near this highway. If the bandits haven't given up,
they might be hiding there, waiting for an opportunity to strike. I need to check the old map for the exact location. I'll also gather some intel on the outer rings. These bandits are causing a commotion. There must be a reason behind it.
Might be related to the Hollow.
Thanks, Proxy. Who would have thought hunting down a gang of bandits would lead to this?
Working with Lighter is quite enjoyable.
It's my pleasure. Same plan for tomorrow. Meet here.
You go back and rest to the rest area after confirming the meeting with time as Faithin. Of course, I have my own ways of gathering. Finally, a fair reward after a flurry of hard work. You light up a time and place over the communicator. With that familiar voice, it's about time for bed. A new day! Your appointment from yesterday should be here by now. Go give Lighter a surprise. My god, they are not holding back with the any windows.
You're here, Proxy.
Guess what news I've brought you?
Oh, did you hear something, Proxy?
You snap your fingers and a fiery red rescuer emerges from the shadows.
Hey, Lighter, my man!
Proxy, who is this?
Commander, did Lighter lose his memory? Doesn't even recognize me. Do I need an introduction?
Yeah, I don't remember you. Go ahead and introduce me, Proxy.
No, that's not how you should react. Shouldn't you be shouting? Even if I forgot everyone, I would never forget my senior, Billy!
Don't joke around, even in a soap opera's like... Even in the soap operas that Caesar secretly watches, nobody says lines like that. Are you more addicted to soap operas than Caesar?
Get to the point, Billy. Get to the point. Got it, manager. Long story short, the manager found Nicole and asked if anyone had recently placed a contract related to the Outer Ring Hollow.
Not only that, but the ones who took it were cunning hares.
Ahaha, as expected of you, Lighter. After all, this is a job involving the Outer Ring. Not everyone is like Boss Nicole, who prioritizes money over their life. The job is to escort a shipment from the Outer Ring's hollow into the city. The cargo is something that the Outer Rings Gas and Oil Company stumbled upon during excavation. An artifact from the old civilization.
Come on, give me some reaction here. I get that the manager already heard this, but Lighter, can't you show a little more excitement?
Oh, wow. So exciting.
Anyway, the manager filled us in on what you've been investigating over the past few days. After we cross-checked, we found that the road you're tracking is the exact route the artifact is being transported through. So the bandits have been eyeing that stretch of road. Their target is likely this artifact. Boss Nicole was over the moon when she found out you're investigating this. She said now she can immediately order me to assist you in dealing with it.
Oh, so this intel broker mentioned that a wealthy merchant from the city is hiring reliable transport teams for jobs in the Outer Ring. So that's what it's about.
Now we've finally identified the target.
Thanks, Proxy. And you too, Billy. Right after Piper gave me the coordinates of the abandoned side road, she said, Lighter, can you handle... Lighter can handle it alone, right? And went off to take a nap.
Billy,
could you lend me a hand with the Proxy? Just for some support?
Proxy, does Lighter not really mind being used by Nicole?
Billy, even if you lower your voice, I can still hear you. We've come this far. There's no reason to just let it go now. Besides, it's fine if someone unrelated, but since it's about you, Billy, it's only right to give you a... Besides, it's fine if it's someone unrelated, but since it's you, since it's about you, Billy, it's only right to give you a hand. Otherwise, would I just leave you and the Proxy alone in the hollow?
Lighter is a good guy. Quick, Billy, say it. Lighter is a good guy.
Lighter, you're a really great guy.
You're welcome.
Now, Lighter, you give the coordinates to the manager. Now, Lighter, you give the coordinates to the manager. When we're ready, let's get going, shall we?
To battle!
We fighting?
What? Starlight, it's time to shine!
That's my fire support, little bro.
Sure you're not hitting the guys I'm already down?
Too weak.
Excellent. Would you like me to play some epic background music for you?
Know your place.
Suggestion. You should be in a good relationship with this agent.
Who wants to die first? Who wants to die first? Or are you just running low on air?
Watch it, man!
We got it, bro. Know your place.
Suggestion. You should be in a good relationship with this agent. Suggestion. You should maintain a good relationship with this agent.
Still got it, bro. Come on, boy.
Suggestion. You should maintain a good relationship with this agent.
Still got it, bro.
Screw you.
Okay.
Thanks, Piper. You're right. The remaining highway gang is indeed hiding in that abandoned junction.
Well, looks like things went smoothly for you. More than smoothly, we even found...
How about leaving a little surprise, Billy?
Huh? Are you telling me to keep quiet? What is Lyder planning?
I have no idea.
Don't worry about it. Lyder is just trying to steal the spotlight again.
Proxy, aren't you curious to see something interesting? You won't have to wait long. Tomorrow's the day when that old civilization artifact gets transported into the city. Right, Billy?
Yes, that's right. Once the artifact is safely escorted tomorrow, my job will be complete.
Let's leave it for tomorrow then. Proxy, get a good rest tonight. You'll have a bit of work to do tomorrow.
Do you really have to keep it a secret?
It's just a little show. Just look forward to it.
Proxy, let him be. If you don't let him keep this secret, he'll be sulking until morning, until next month. Like, how did I miss my chance to show off in front of Proxy? I see. I'll keep your secret safe until tomorrow, Lyder, my brother. Though I still don't quite understand why you want to keep it hidden.
Mm-hmm. Alright then, see you tomorrow, Proxy.
After Billy valiantly vouches for Lyder, he strides off with Piper to catch up on old times with Big Daddy. Lyder stands in the hot outer ring breeze with his head slightly lowered, as if thinking about something. Meeting your gaze, Lyder flashes a grin at you.
Why does no one have any sense of fun or creativity?
Is this why people say that you're a big show-off?
Is that so? Well, doesn't sound like a bad thing to me.
I think you're pretty fun this way.
Well then, Proxy, you can be my audience. I'm quite good at winning over a crowd. I won't disappoint you. At least, I hope not.
Despite his voice carrying a hint of laughter, Lyder's expression appeared to dim. Is it time to change subject? You chat with Lyder about Billy's combat performance today and learn Lyder takes on a very respectful tone despite Billy clearly outside. There's no way you're ever gonna mention this to Billy. You line up a time for tomorrow's meeting and head back to your resting place.
It's a new day!
Yeah.
It feels like you could hear the humming of motors while you were sleeping. Is that how dreams sound in the outer ring?
It's nearly time. Better go meet up with Lyder.
Morning, Proxy. Ready to head out?
Where's your bike? If you're riding a bike, what about me? Never seen Billy on a motorcycle
before.
Question, is riding a motorcycle considered intelligent driving?
Nope, unless it's the other way around.
On the contrary,
no. I don't have that kind of capability.
That's not driving, that'd be a stunt performance.
Is Billy's joke time over?
I'm just warming up for your performance. Look, Proxy is smiling so happily.
God, they are... I genuinely feel like they're trying to push a ship between Bell and Light right now. I'm for it, but... like, it... It does seem like they are hinting a little more than other characters' performance. Lighter has thought of a more comprehensive plan for escorting the goods. Though, it's to prevent the bandits from pulling any more tricks. Let me talk to the proxy. Lighter gestures for you to come closer and whispers his plan to you. So, proxy, isn't this safer than a motorcycle escort? I'll wait and see. Stay tuned.
Got to battle.
Oh god, this is endless. Enemies respawn faster. You know what? Let's just try it all.
Only the brave will win.
Let's fire it up.
We fight.
I haven't used Piper yet. Let's see. Hey, this is supposed to be endless. Boo.
These guys really put in a lot of effort, but in the end, they're just a bunch of stupid thieves.
So, what's the story?
Sounds like you've got it all figured out. So what's going on?
Do you remember the gang we took down a couple of days ago? The one holed up in the refinery?
The one that was used as a decoy?
I remember. It was the gang that Loudmouth asked the Sons of Caledon to take down. You and Caesar both said they were so weak they scattered as soon as the fighting started.
That's right.
I found a map in their hideout marked with some routes, which led to everything that happened afterward. At first, I thought their greedy presence on this route got them taken out by the highway gang, who used the Sons of Caledon to do their dirty work. But the gangsters who tried to hijack us today confirmed my suspicions. The true masterminds were, in fact, the gang holed up in the refinery.
Ooh. They're the ones who tried the carjacking today?
Wait, you mean the carjackers today were the same group?
Yep, it was the same crew. Their quick defeat was all just an act. They faked their retreat to go off the radar and save their strength until the day of the carjacking. The gang at the highway junction was their real target. They wanted to use the Sons of Caledon to take them out.
Guess they outsmarted themselves in the end.
They really outsmarted themselves. If they hadn't tried to be so clever by coaxing the Sons of Caledon to do their dirty work, we might not have even noticed the carjacking at all. Well, they managed to get caught between the former and current Red Scarf, losing to both. What are the odds? Is that bad luck? Or some twisted kind of good luck?
They really put a lot of thought into this, didn't they? That artifact of the old civilization they were after must be worth a lot.
Before Leiter could finish speaking, a hand clapped down hard on his shoulder.
Yo, Proxy! Little bro! What you talking about?
Has that batch of goods been delivered?
Yep! After getting through the outer ring, the rest of the trip went smoothly. Not a single red light. Could it be my lucky day today?
What exactly were the goods, Billy?
Billy! Leiter and I were just talking about the cargo. Did you see it get unloaded? What kind of artifact of the old civilization was it?
We're guessing it must be something pretty valuable. That's why this whole mess happened.
Oh, that would make sense. The client's eyes lit up as soon as they mentioned the artifact. They said it was something like a symbol of the old civilization's industry and highway culture. A pure white statue that was once known worldwide. And it existed wherever there were roads. So it must be pretty awesome. But...
a stop sign?
What?
Stop sign.
Well, maybe I don't know much about the old civilization.
It's a road sign.
The thing kind of looks like a white... marshmallow? No, wait. Rubber ring? No, that's not it.
White marshmallow.
A tire! Yeah, a tire! It looks like a person made from white tires. It's kind of weird. But it's huge! Is civilization actually considered this thing a symbol of industry and highway culture?
Uh-huh.
Maybe people of the old civilization just had unique aesthetic tastes. Since you're both here, how about we go grab a couple drinks?
Wait!
So it's me? Fucking Michelin, man.
Let's go find Bernice. She can do more than just mix our drinks. You coming, bro?
Okay, hold on. God, I hate how... Okay. Well, okay.
Glider looks quite relaxed. Not too bad. No people involved. Thanks, Proxy. Doing it for the money. Yep. Okay, so... Okay, those are what unlock it later. I can do all the duels.
You want a glass of nitro fuel?
Let's go. Hard mode, you need to defeat enemies, perform perfect dodges. Nope, 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 nope.
Dodge. Gotcha! Why is it so fucking loud?
Can go from changing settings constantly. You should not be fucking doing that.
Don't overdo it, Denise.
Make way for the undefeated champion.
Watch your spoon. Don't
overdo it, please. Okay. Pardon?
Only the brat. We fighting? Take me.
Oops.
Excellent. Would you like me to play some epic background music for him?
Oh my fucking god!
I'm unstoppable!
What is actually the way to properly? Surprise uppercut. Okay, whatever.
Only the brave will.
Want a glass of? Ooh, so sleepy.
Okay, whatever. Also, why was the audio, like, actually kind of lower than others?
Only the brave.
Let's.
I have two.
Want a glass of.
We fighting? Take me.
Yeah.
Excellent. Would you like me to play some epic background music for him? He makes a good point. Suggestion. You should be in a good relationship with the agent.
No, you're right.
He makes a good point.
You should maintain a good relationship with this agent. Okay, jeez. Help me, please, please don't. Oh, right. Quick assist, perfect assist, impact, increase. It's a finishing move on an enemy. Rock-a-taboo. Let's go. Doctor.
Watch out!
Something so trivial doesn't need a champion.
Counter! Solid hit!
Things are about to get violent.
Copy that.
Any last words?
Nope. Nothing to it.
Target confirmed.
What's your honor really worth?
Perfect teamwork! Blazing!
There it is!
Start right now! Be ready!
I still got it. Nice.
I'm at your disposal.
Touch, you have my complete
Sokaku, ready! Is it work time? Is food included?
Shark bangle. That's cool.
Your honor really worth.
I need to figure out how
his ice performance actually work, like, how to trigger things with him. Because at this point, I just mash buttons, honestly. I don't know what I'm doing. What do I use? This one.
I'm at your disposal.
Wanna see the-
I shall
follow- Is it work time?
It's up!
Ready?
I'm here, so we're good.
Automatically gains morale over time at a right. When startup light punches or jab combo targets, ice and fire resistance are reduced. Huh, interesting. Okay.
Want to see the red scarf?
What do it?
Okay, also, I chose the one that, which one did I choose? Because I think I chose the one that is, not good for single enemies.
Okay. Okay, unlocks a bit later. Okay, all that's left are the Denny's. Oh. Huh. Attack characters fall in. I don't know. Stuff things. List of engines. Okay, where are the Battle Pass ones? My agents.
Only the brave will win.
That's me.
Because you have yours. Wait, what is this? Upon hitting basic attack. Wait. Oh, now that's hers. Okay. Nope. What the hell is this? Brimstone? Oh, that's Soldier. What? Oh.
Shite. Huh. Why the fuck? Okay. You know what? I am going to get that attack one then. Cause... Cannon Rudder. Yay.
Touch me too.
Hey, Ellen. No. You want something better? Replace. Enhance. Yay, there we go. Why was I keeping that on? Okay. I don't know anymore. I don't know what I do.
Time for some.
We fight one.
Want to see the
ready and waiting.
Okay.
What a na.
Yeah, finish that one. I haven't finished this one. I'm slowly going through it. Yeah, I'm just gonna call it here. Mm-hmm.